Let's look at these lies, denials and cover-ups. On the same day, former policeman Paul Erasmus made these statements about Stanza Bopape. I asked the former commissioner of police, General Johan van Merwe, about his allegations and charges made by the Goldstone Commission about dirty tricks.
Ek kan dit onomwonde sê. Ek is nie bewus van een moord wat plaasgevind het terwyl ek kommissaris was, of selfs voor die tyd. Is ek nie bewus van een moord wat plaasgevind het rondom dit wie vir so 'n moord verantwoordelik is nie.
Van der Merwe is now asking for amnesty for his part in the cover-up of the Bopape murder. Last week it became known that Vlakplaas satellite groups in KwaZulu-Natal murdered ANC activists as recently as 1994. That was towards the end of F.W. de Klerk's term as president, and more than 4 years after Vlakplaas was exposed as nothing else than a death squad. Mr. de Klerk became involved in a heated exchange with some ANC politicians this week.
My hands are clean, and it's nonsense to say that I knew about it. It is a lie and it is untrue that I ever had a strategy to, through violence, destabilize, on the one hand, people that we were negotiating with.
We have nothing to do with this quarrel between politicians. But we at the Truth Commission Special Report have the duty to say to Mr. de Klerk, we are not saying you killed anybody or that you ordered any assassinations. But why does Mr. de Klerk and his former colleagues shy away from taking responsibility for these violations? Why do they keep on telling us they had no idea that this type of thing was going on? If we as citizens and we as journalists knew who were doing the killing, and we wrote about it then, how could the political bosses of the killers not have known? I want to remind Mr. de Klerk of what he told me in an interview on the 3rd of February 1994.
But I see in your manifesto, and I quote you, what you just said, the National Party does not kill people. The National Party does not threaten people. And again, I am sure the relatives of Steve Biko and Dulcie September and David Webster and Anton Lubovsky would want me to ask you, when did you change your mind? When did you stop doing that?
Well, firstly, in some of the instances you are referring to accusations made where no proof exists. If at any time in the past and now and in the future security forces are involved in breaking the law, it's wrong. And I have, without fear, fearlessly ordered full investigation. Where there's evidence, we will prosecute. But the National Party of
today, like the CCB, we had evidence. We had a commission, we had evidence.
Yes, and we had one of the best judges and one of the best prosecutors, and they couldn't uncover evidence which led really to prosecution, because people, in as much as they were guilty, apparently covered their tracks so well that no evidence could be obtained. And we live in a civilized country. You cannot charge a man without evidence. We cannot go back to the law of the jungle because of rumors, because of even well-founded suspicions. But without evidence in a civilized country where you say we adhere to the rule of law, you wait until you get evidence.
Who killed all these people?
But yes, obviously many people, including I, would like to get the real facts.
And then on the 21st of August last year, I asked Mr. de Klerk again why he allowed the killings to go on.
What is now coming out of court is that that unit continued to murder people.
Which is wrong, which must be absolutely...
Maybe Mangani was killed quite recently by that unit. You did not disband that unit. What you're saying now is you didn't have enough evidence. How much more evidence...
I was at no stage aware of any unit carrying out assassinations. The Vlakplaas unit, as it was explained to me, had a totally different objective, a totally different field of activity. I was never part, as I've said, of any decision to assassinate or murder anybody. I totally distance myself from assassination, even in the fight which we had. Assassination is wrong, and I would never have supported it. And if I had any inclination, any indication that there were actually people committing assassinations and that there was a unit which was used for that, I would have acted violently myself.
Did you know that could see as evidence? He was the commander of that unit. He came out in 1989 and said, I was the commander.
This when Dirk Coetzee said that, he was speaking to a judicial commission of inquiry chaired by an appellate court judge. And there was a whole process of investigation taking place. Surely one must await the judge's report before you then act.